Hello everyone, this is Manoj from Tanya Technotronics. In this video, I am going to show the working of a 555 timer. These 555 timers are very stable and very cheap and reliable. And it has some features like these 555 timers can be operated in both monostable multivibrator mode as well as it can be operated in astable multivibrator mode. These 555 timers has adjustable duty cycle features. And coming to the voltage and current ratings, it has voltage rating ranging from 4.5 to 16 volts and the output current of 200 milliamps. Let's look at the pin configuration. These 555 timers comes in 8 pin DIP packages. Coming to the pin configurations, the first pin is a ground pin, second pin is a trigger pin. This pin is responsible for transition of states from set to reset. And one more note is like for the second pin, the output of the timer depends on the amplitude of the external trigger pulse applied to this pin. Coming to the third pin, it's an output pin. This is the output of the timer is available at this pin. This is the reset pin, that is the fourth pin for resetting the timer. Coming to the fifth pin, it's a control voltage pin. The function of this terminal is to control the threshold and trigger levels. Coming to the 6th pin, it's a threshold pin. The amplitude of the voltage applied to this pin is responsible for the set state. The 7th pin is the discharge pin. This is called discharge terminal because the discharge and the charging of the capacitor takes place at this pin based on the transistor, saturation and cutoff conditions. And this is the VCC pin. Here I have rigged up test PWM circuit for the demo purposes and trying to control the pulse width using the variable potentiometer, and you can see the output with respect to the on and off state of the LED. Let us see the demo. Here I am changing the variable resistance with the help of variable potentiometer. I am going to increase the resistance. Now you can see the on state is more than compared to the off state. See, the on state is more. Let's try with reverse case. Again, I'm trying to reduce, decrease the resistance. Now you can see the off state is more compared to the on state. This is how it works. Thank you for watching this video. For any related queries, please feel free to contact us at info@tanyatech.com.